Hi dear viewers, today I am going to recite a very illustrious poem of Percy Bysshe Shelley, Ode to the West Wind. O wild west wind, thou breath of autumn's being, thou from whose unseen presence the leaves dead are driven, like ghosts from an enchanter fleeing, yellow and black and pale and hectic red, pestilence is stricken multitudes. O thou who chariotest to their dark wintry bed, the wind seats where they lie cold and low, each like a corpse within its grave, until thine azure sister of the spring shall blow her clarion o'er the dreaming earth, and feel driving sweet birds like flocks to feed in air, with living hues and orders plain and heal, wild spirit, which art moving everywhere, destroyer and preserver, here, oh here. Thou on whose stream, mid the deep sky's commotion, loose clouds like earth's decaying leaves are shed, shook from the tangled boughs of heaven and ocean, angels of rain and lightning, there are spread on the blue surface of thine airy surge, like the bright hair uplifted from the head of some fierce maenad, even from the dim verse of the horizon to the zenith sight, the locks of the approaching storm, thou darts of the dying year, to which this closing night will be the dome of a sepulchre, vaulted with all the congregated might of vapors, from whose solid atmosphere black rain and fire and hail with burst, O hear. Thou who didst waken from his summer's dream the blue Mediterranean, where he lay lulled by the coil of his crystalline streams beside a pumice isle in Bay's Bay, and saw in sleep old palaces and towers quivering within the waves' intenser day, all overgrown with azure moss and flowers, so sweet the sense faints picturing them. Thou for whose path the Atlantic's level powers cleave themselves into chasms, while far below the sea blooms and oozy woods, which where the sapless foliage of the ocean know thy voice, and suddenly grow grey with fear, and tremble and despoil themselves, O hear. If I were a dead leaf thou mightest bear, if I were a swift cloud to fly with thee, a wave to pound beneath thy power and share the impulse of thy strength, only less free than thou, O uncontrollable, if even I were as in my boyhood, and could be the comrade of thy wanderings over heaven, as then, when to outstrip thy sky's speed, scarce seemed a vision, I would ne'er have striven. As thus with thee in prayer in my sore need, oh, lift me as a wave, a leaf, a cloud, I fall upon the thorns of life I bleed, a heavy weight of hours a chained and bound, one to like thee tameless and swift and proud. Make me thy lyre even as the forest is, what if my lips are falling like its own, the tumult of thy mighty harmonies will take from both a deep autumnal tone. Sweet though in sadness be thou with spirit fierce, my spirit be thou me impetuous one, drive my dead thoughts over the universe, like withered leaves to quicken a new birth, and by the incantation of this verse, scatter as from an unextinguished heart, ashes and spirits my words among mankind, be thou my lips to unawakened earth, the trumpet of a prophecy, O wind, if winter comes, can spring be far behind? Thank you, dear viewers, for listening.